Welcome to a brief monsoon outlook, produced in conjunction with Monsoon Awareness Week. The week of June 8th through the 13th has been designated as Monsoon Awareness Week in Arizona. This outlook is produced in cooperation with the National Weather Services in Tucson, Flagstaff, and Las Vegas, as well as information from the Climate Prediction Center. The North American monsoon is defined as a shift in the overall wind pattern from the typical dry spring westerly flow throughout the atmosphere to a southerly or southeasterly flow. This wind pattern shift is due to the development and position of a summertime subtropical high pressure system. Once this high pressure system becomes established over the region, moisture is capable of being pulled north into Arizona from both the Pacific and Gulf of Mexico, eventually becoming manifested into thunderstorms. The position of this high will dictate whether the monsoon is active with frequent thunderstorms or inactive with little or no thunderstorm activity. When the high is located over eastern New Mexico, Colorado, and the central high plains, this is generally favorable for thunderstorms in Arizona. However, if the high shifts into northern Mexico or becomes situated almost directly over Arizona, this scenario is generally unfavorable for thunderstorm development. Looking back at last summer highlights how the position of the subtropical high modulates excessive heat, moisture return, and thunderstorm activity during the monsoon season. These maps depict periods of excessive heat over Arizona last summer, and the red colors show the center of the subtropical high. In all these cases, the extreme heat and lack of thunderstorms, the high pressure was centered directly over Arizona or northern Mexico, keeping moisture trapped to the south. Conversely, these maps show the weather pattern during active thunderstorm periods across the state last year. These time frames followed the periods of extreme heat as a high pressure system that initially limited moisture return eventually moved to the north or east of the state. This created a flow pattern out of the south and the east, which brought moisture and thunderstorm activity to Arizona. We will closely be watching the evolution of similar patterns this summer to determine when and where the most active thunderstorms or lack of thunderstorms will develop. So what are some of the weather factors that could influence the monsoon flow pattern? Many times a subtropical high will set up and become quasi-stationary over regions of extreme drought where soil moisture is significantly lacking. This regime provides positive feedback mechanisms where the hot, dry weather bakes the ground and reinforces the strength of the high pressure system, and so on. Outside of California, the most extreme drought this year is located over West Texas, Western Oklahoma, Southeast Colorado, and Western Kansas. This area of drought is very similar to last year, and we did indeed see prolonged periods of the subtropical high situated over the high plains last year. While drought occurrence is not the only mechanism to force the location of the subtropical high, the current drought areas could be favorable for good moisture flow into Arizona this year. Several studies have attempted to link the conditions in the Pacific Ocean to the onset and magnitude of monsoon thunderstorm activity in Arizona. Although this relationship does not hold every year, there is some correlation that shows when El Nino conditions are present, that is warmer than normal sea surface temperatures over the central and eastern equatorial Pacific, with a positive Pacific decadal oscillation, that is warmer than normal sea surface temperatures along the immediate western United States coast, the flow pattern stays more westerly, trapping moisture in Mexico or deflecting the moisture surges eastward into New Mexico. After a couple years of ENSO neutral status, that is either neither La Nina or El Nino, an El Nino event is rapidly developing over the Pacific this year. Warming of the Pacific waters has been persistent, and a full-scale El Nino episode is expected by the end of the summer and the fall season. The Pacific decadal oscillation was much more evident earlier in this year, with a far more negative PDO measure. But now that might be slowly shifting into a positive phase, with warmer waters now hugging the west coast of the United States. While this could conceptually lead to drier conditions this monsoon season, this linkage and correlation is still fairly weak, especially with the atmosphere not yet responding to the developing El Nino conditions. So the big question is, how is this developing El Nino going to affect the monsoon season, and will it affect the monsoon season? This figure shows the monsoon season rainfall for Tucson, Flagstaff, and Phoenix for the past six established or rapidly developing summertime El Nino events. As can be seen, while at least half the years have had below average rainfall during these monsoon years, there were several years with average or above average rainfall coincident with El Nino. Therefore, while there may be some tendency for below average rainfall during the monsoon season during El Nino events, this trend certainly does not hold true every year and is not necessarily statistically significant. The truth is, we really have very little skill in predicting the strength and persistence of the North American monsoon over the whole year. Not only are conditions in the atmosphere changing throughout the summer season, allowing periods of active and periods of inactive thunderstorms, but the thunderstorms and heavy rainfall produced by the monsoon flow are typically very isolated in nature. An example here can be seen from last year, where amounts varied widely not only across central Arizona, but across the entire state. Case in point, across southeast Arizona last July, Douglas saw its wettest month ever, while Tucson over the whole monsoon season saw one of its drier monsoons. Active monsoon periods can last a few days or several weeks and can become aligned over one area. In this example, in far southern Nevada and northern Arizona, they received persistent thunderstorm activity, while parts of south central and southeast Arizona only saw occasional activity. With conflicting climate signals across the Pacific Ocean and towards the Rockies, we look towards dynamic climate models for any signal during the monsoon season. Right now, there are some weak indications from these models that the northward moisture flux will be present and persistent enough through the entire summer to potentially produce above average precipitation. However, this is only a very weak signal, and this 35-40% chance of above average rainfall on the right here still means that there's a 27-32% chance of below average rainfall throughout the monsoon season. So it's really just a weak signal. In summary, there are several conflicting and not particularly reliable climate signals out there this year that would indicate a wetter or drier monsoon season. Even in the best case years where there would be some signal, we still only have limited prediction skill given the aerial and temporal nature of thunderstorm activity. Regardless of the strength of amount or activity during this monsoon season, there will always be periods of thunderstorms with lightning, strong winds, blowing dust, and heavy rain. So prepare for these thunderstorms ahead of time. Know what to do to keep yourself and your family safe by reviewing the information presented in this past Monsoon Awareness Week. For more information, please visit our website at www.weather.gov/phoenix for up-to-date information and the latest forecasts and warning products. As always, NOAA Weather Radio is a good outlet to be alerted with the most recent watches, warnings, and advisories. The National Weather Service in Phoenix is also on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.